Did you know that the 1% of the world's wealth is now, or I should say, the 1% richest people in the world now own more than half of the world's entire wealth? And that's incredible and staggering. And the accumulation of assets in hands of a few will tend to erode democracy because there's fewer people with a great amount of power, right? Well, this video isn't exactly about that, but there is an analogy that I want to talk about in terms of content and attention, right? Your attention is limited every single day, just like your time. And you can only give a certain amount of time to viewing a blog post, watching a video, listening to a podcast, whatever it is. And my question to you is, where is your attention going? To whom is your attention going? Is it going to famous people? Because think about this, the most famous 1%, the 1% most famous people in any field probably own more than half of the attention of everybody consuming content in that field, right? So like the Tony Robbinses, the Marie Forleos, the Brene Browns, the Tim Ferrisses, right? They are getting all of our attention. And so what happens is small creators like you and me and many others and some of your friends who are small businesses and trying to make a go at it, trying to be consistent in their blogging or in their videos or in the podcast, but they're getting discouraged. They're getting discouraged because nobody is commenting on their thing. You might be getting discouraged because nobody is commenting on your Facebook posts or on your YouTube videos or whatever it is. And it's because the rest of us are paying attention to the Tony Robbins and the Gary Vaynerchuks and the Marie Forleos and the Amy Porterfields and the et cetera, et cetera. So why don't we, and this is a bit of a public service announcement, maybe, let's all give a little bit of time every day, if we can, to a small creator. If you're spending an hour a day, right, reading blog posts, watching videos, listening to podcasts, whatever, how about giving even just 5 or 10 minutes of that hour every day that you consume content to a small creator, somebody who has no comments on their blog posts or their videos? And you can make such a big difference when you comment on somebody's postings that don't usually have any comments. I'm not talking about me. I don't think I'm a small creator anymore. I'm now probably a medium creator, right? So I'm not talking about me. You don't have to comment on my stuff because I get enough comments already. But comment on your friends' stuff who don't have any comments. Or find a random creator in some area that you want to consume content in, some area of your interest. And don't just watch their thing or read their thing, but comment on it. So what should you do when you comment? Two things. One is tell them what you liked about that piece of content. Now, I know they're a small creator. They're just, they're not as, maybe they're, they, maybe you don't find them as brilliant as some famous person, but they also have good points about their content, right? They're not the most brilliant writer in the world. They're not the best looking video maker in the world, but they have something good about that piece of content. So the first thing to do is tell them what you liked about that piece of content. If it's a blog post, you can highlight or call out a particular passage or a particular phrase that you really liked or a particular paragraph. If it's a podcast, you can say, "Oh, I really liked it when you guys talked about that. That was helpful," right? If it's a video, say, "Hey, really great. Between minute 1, 36 seconds, you said whatever it is." Makes such a difference for that person. Think about it. For you too. I mean, when a random person or even a friend, right, comments on your thing and nobody else has commented, wow, it feels so good. It can actually inspire somebody to make content for a few more weeks if they were discouraged. I mean, it's been weeks or months that nobody has commented on their thing, or days or weeks, right? Nobody's commented, or maybe two other friends. And sometimes we tend to, this is true for all of us, we tend to discount the likings and comments of our own friends. Ah, so and so doesn't matter. They're just a friend. They're just trying to be supportive, right? So let's first of all not do that, because our friends who take the time, their precious limited time every day of content consumption, they may only have 1 hour content consumption, and they have to consume all these famous people's stuff, and then they take the time to consume yours, and they take the time to like it or comment on it. Don't discount our own friends' support of our content. Okay, number one. But number two, when a stranger comments on our thing, we're like, whoa, I don't know this person. This person doesn't have to support me. And yet they are taking the time to comment. Makes such a difference. So start with your friends, of course. You know, continue supporting your friends. Tell your friends not to discount the fact. No, don't say, hey, I don't discount my comment. No. Support you. Start with your friends. Secondly, is take a little bit of time every day or every week to support a random creator that you don't know. Okay, it makes such a difference for them. It could really change the direction of their content creation, right? It could really inspire them for another couple of weeks. Okay, so I mentioned two things to do when you comment. One is tell them what's working. Okay, tell them what you like specifically, and two is give them feedback on what you would like them to talk more about, okay? And maybe suggestions on how they could be even better next time. And the suggestions and the feedback, I would suggest that you do this privately. Praise publicly, critique privately, right? That's a general rule of thumb. It's good for human relationships. So publicly comment on what you liked about it. And say, oh, I hope you talk, keep talking more about XYZ topic that you're talking about. It's so great. Or I really like this passage. Brilliant. Amazing. Or so helpful. It's so true. What a great reminder, et cetera. And then second thing is privately say, hey, I'd also like to see you talk about this. That'd be great. I mean, or hey, maybe next time you could try starting the video, immediately with talking about the thing rather than saying, hey, it's good to have you here. And who's here? And, whatever you want to suggest, or the blog post. Hey, I really like your blog post. Be great next time. Maybe you could start with a story. I think that's very captivating. It's just, critique in a kind, but that constructive way. Okay. So that's what you do when you comment or suggest. I want to suggest three things that we do to support small creators. Again, not me, but other people that have barely any comments on their thing. Okay. One is to comment publicly and critique privately so that they can improve. Otherwise, how will people don't know how to improve until you tell them. Really, I don't know how to improve until you tell me. So that's why I'm always asking for feedback. Like, how can I improve? Everybody's in their own head. I'm in my own head. You're in your own head. We have no idea how to improve until somebody outside of us, says, hey, try this or do this. Okay. So one is comment publicly and critique privately. Two is to buy from a small creator. Somebody who is just trying to make a go of their business and who may have a product or a service. If you can't afford their 6-month coaching package, don't do that. But buy their book, buy their workshop, buy their class, something you can afford. And this is true with friends too, right? Your friends, they might discount completely your comments, your likes, whatever. That's just, so and so. They're just a friend. But they don't discount your purchases. Your friends might actually say, oh, you don't have to buy that from me. You're a friend. I should be able to give. No. Because I'm a friend, if anybody should buy from you, I should buy from you because I'm a friend, right? Your friends shouldn't be giving you their products and services for free. You should be buying from, like, if you know they sh you should be paying them because you want to support them as a friend. So one is comment publicly and critique privately. Two is to buy services from small creators, especially your friends. But just even a random creator, that's fine too, but especially your friends. And three is to give a testimonial or a review, especially a positive review. If it's a negative review, send that to them privately. But if it's a positive review or testimonial, it makes a night and day difference. I mean, there are some testimonials on my website that are years old. Now, I think that's still true about those testimonials are still true about me. That's why I keep them there, I hope. But yeah, your testimonial could make years of difference for somebody. Years of difference. So taking that extra 15 minutes after you buy and use something to write a testimonial changes somebody's life, changes somebody's business. You really, really make a big difference when you do that. Do you realize that? That's one of the biggest differences you can make is to write someone a testimonial. So anyway, comment publicly, critique privately on small creators. Creator is the term nowadays for people who make content. Bloggers, video makers, podcast creators, image makers, whatever it is. So comment publicly and critique privately for small creators. Two is to buy the products and services, especially from your friends, but also other small creators. And three is to take the extra 15 to 30 minutes to write a review or send some private feedback. It will change somebody's business, change someone's life. So I hope this is helpful. Thanks for those of you who care enough to join me live and commenting. Jen, super, super thanks. Sharon, thank you so much there. So anyway, go forward, comment and critique, comment publicly, critique privately, buy whatever you can afford from small creators. I'm not talking about me, just other people who are just kind of making a go at their business. And three is to review publicly or suggest privately about their products and services. So be well, make a difference, and I hope this also helps other people make a difference in your business. Take care. Oh, I've got to say one more thing, one more thing. Because of this idea, I'm going to start creating a thread every Monday. I'm actually changing my content schedule. I'll go more into that in the coming weeks. So instead of three new videos and blog posts a week, I'm going to do two now. But I'm going to have other things on the other days that are more, I think they'll keep things more diverse and interesting. So on Mondays, sometimes at around 9 a.m., sometimes around 3 p.m., so to give people different time zones. On Mondays, I will be starting a thread that encourages people to support each other, especially smaller creators. So whether that's about sharing what your products and services are, or sharing what your blog is, or where you post your content, or sharing another small creator that you really want to support, give me ideas. What do you think that Monday thread could be to help small creators? Sharing offerings, sharing blog posts, sharing other small creators. What else? What other ideas? Let me know what you think. So Mondays, look for that thread and participate so that other people can discover you and you can discover other people and support them. So be well, and I look forward to that very much. Have a great weekend. Have a great week.